I've always put off learning to weld because the cost of a machine that will cover all my bases seemed to be incredibly expensive, and it was just something I couldn't justify as a hobbyist working in my shop at home. And the cost of a 3-in-1 welder, even from somewhere like Harbour Freight, is still going to set you back $600 to over $1,000. It's still only DC TIG, so therefore it's going to be very difficult to do magnesium and aluminium welding. And even then, you still have to make additional purchases. The gas bottle, the regulator, the tungsten, the filler rod. And I've always put off trying those cheaper welders that you see online, thinking that they're going to be complete junk and they're going to cause more problems and frustration than they'll actually solve. So today we're going to put my initial assumption to test. Vevor have reached out to see if I'd like to try their 3-in-1 welder. And it's only $290 US. And we'll get started trying out their Flux core setup. It doesn't require any additional purchases, and it covers the majority of the type of welding that we're going to come across as hobbyists at home. Watching professional welders review products like this on YouTube, getting amazing results, isn't really representative of what you can expect to achieve at home. However, I've never done any sort of welding myself. Therefore, this will give you a true representation as to what someone like yourself that may not have any experience can actually achieve. So in today's short video, we're going to cover unboxing the welder, going through what it comes with, setting it up for basic flux core welding, doing some welds, and at the end of the video, I'll give you my feedback and whether I think it's worth the investment in the machine. This is Vevor's Mig 270. It's a 3-in-1 welder, and it's capable of doing wire feed, TIG and stick, and it comes with a number of accessories. Firstly, of course, the manual. And they supply a few different tips, clamps, and also a nozzle. And then the wire feed setup itself, and this can do both flux core and MIG. A ground clamp, which feels a little bit chintzy, I suppose. The wire feed next, which is flux core in 0.8mm. Then you have your TIG setup, and it comes with most of what you need. The collet body, collet, the gas cup, heat shield, and of course the torch itself. However, it doesn't come with any tungsten. You'll have to purchase that separately. And then a very anemic set of goggles. In fact, I took the lenses out of these goggles. They're dangerous and I don't recommend you use them. That's actually what's going to be covering the camera lens when we do some welding a bit later. My advice is just to throw these away. Purchase yourself a face shield. It's so much better. It's just not worth the risk. Electrode holder for stick welding. And actually this feels really nice. I can't complain about that at all. Your hose, as well as your brush, and again, throw it away. Get yourself a wire wheel. Here's the face shield that I bought, and I think it cost me about $13 US. The gloves were about $4 or $5 US, so you really don't need to spend that much money to be able to get yourself up and running with the basics. So we're going to be doing flux core welding, and that requires a positive ground. So we'll slip that ground in, and it does show you the plus sign. You can't really go wrong here. And on the back of the machine, you've got your on switch, you've got your little gas bayonet, and then on the front, we're going to remove the plastic cover and we're going to put the wire feed connector in here. And again, you can't get that wrong. It's all oriented. It can only go in one way. To get set up, we need to take the side panel off. And in fact, on the side panel, it does give you all the instructions for where you need to set your ground, whether it be positive or negative, depending on the type of welding that we're going to be doing. And then to the left-hand side, we're going to take off this tension latch and the roller will come up. We remove this little thumb wheel. And this gives us access to your drive roller. Now this comes in 1mm or 0.8mm, depending on what wire you're going to be using. But just note that whatever number is facing out, in this case one, is actually set up for 0.8mm wire. And then lastly, our little thumb wheel goes on. We then install our wire. In this case, as mentioned, it's 0.8mm flux core. That washer goes back on, the tension spring, and then lastly, our little thumb wheel goes on. And we're just going to go to snug, don't overdo it. We're going to lower down the top roller, the latch goes on, and just apply a small amount of tension for now. We'll finish that off later. A nice little feature of this welder is that it comes with a wire feed switch, and it just eases that wire, makes installation nice and quick. We're going to be welding this chainsaw bar, and it's about 4.7mm wide, and this welder doesn't actually come with any recommended settings as to where to start with. However, if you Google Miller Welding Calculator, it will be a good place to get you going. It might not be ideal, but at least it's a place to start. Select the first link, and we're going to be doing flux core welding. Then we're going to have to select steel, and we're 4.8mm or 3/16 of an inch. And then all the information comes up for the recommended settings. So we're going to set the machine onto MIG, we're going to go and adjust the voltage to the recommended starting point of about 15 volts. The wire speed and current are actually combined. You can only adjust your current. Therefore, we're going to set this at 190, which was the miller's recommended setting. I really would have liked it if Vevor included that starting chart. It would have been really handy and it wouldn't have cost any more to do so. And before we can do any welding, we're going to have to clean all this rust off. And then we're going to go over with a bit of alcohol. Now, I don't recommend using anything like brake cleaner that might have chlorine in it. I'm trying this anti-spatter spray and it didn't really work great for me. It's probably me doing something wrong here. And I actually had the welding plug set into a multi-port, and you'll actually notice that I tripped the breaker on that. So I took that out, I plugged it straight into the wall, and I didn't have any problems after. And each time I'm going to go back and I'll just adjust one of the two dials and I'll just see how it affects the penetration and the size of the weld. And in this case, I'm just going to increase the voltage to 16 volts. And each time I'll keep coming back and making those small adjustments. And I'll let you be the judge of these welds. I can't offer much because I haven't got any experience. However, for non-structural, non-critical parts, I'm actually really happy. And I'm only going to be using this welder for mower decks, maybe removing bolts where necessary, or piping, tubing. As I said, non-structural, non-critical components that just really need to be held together. But please share your thoughts in the comment section below. I'd really like to know. And all I can really say, I suppose, is just the more voltage I gave, the less crown I got to the weld. But any advice is much appreciated. At $290, the welder offers so much value. It's got much higher amperage range than what you'll get from Harbour Freight, and it's 2 to 4 times cheaper. I really dislike the fact that they give you these cheap glasses. It doesn't come with a face shield, it doesn't come with a decent chipping hammer or a wire brush, but really we're just nitpicking. These small things are so easy to buy, they're so cheap and so affordable, that really it doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things. And if you think this welder is going to fit your needs, I've actually got a discount code to give you 5% more off in the description below. Also in the description below, I've linked 3 channels: Klaus from Hobby Motor, Ken from Ken Small Engines, and lastly Hank, Henry Morosky from Big Dog Repairs. They've all been excellent and given me advice and help with setting up and using the welder, and I hope you enjoy their videos as much as I do. And if you enjoyed today's video, I've actually reviewed their mini metal lathe, which I've used to make so many different parts that I've been unable to source. I hope you enjoy that video. I hope you enjoy today's video. Till next time, I'll catch you soon.